Now, it makes this particular research quite different than a lot of other research in reference to nitrate-containing foods. In this case, the study utilized beetroot juice. Is we are dealing with the oral microbiome. Now, the oral microbiome has a profound effect on the rest of an individual's biology. And you're going to understand that in a second as we delve into the research. But to begin with, the research was a very short study, basically two 10-day periods. And it worked with individuals which were relatively healthy at the age of 70 to 80 years of age. Now, what is most exceptional about this research is the expediency and the efficiency in which the oral microbiome was changed in a very, very positive way. So let us begin with the research as follows. Changes in mouth bacteria after drinking beetroot juice may promote healthy aging. Drinking beetroot juice promotes a mix of mouth bacteria associated with healthier blood vessels and brain function, according to a new study of people aged 70 to 80. Beetroot and other foods, including lettuce, spinach, and celery, are rich in inorganic nitrate. Please do not confuse with organic food, inorganic food. Different in reference to chemical composition. And many oral bacteria play a role in turning nitrate to nitric oxide, which helps to regulate blood vessels and neurotransmission chemicals, messages in the brain. Older people tend to have a lower nitric oxide production, and this is associated with poor vascular blood vessel and cognitive brain health, how it all works together along the same freeway pattern. In the new study by the University of Exeter, 26 healthy older people took part in two 10-day supplementation periods, one with nitrate-rich beetroot juice and another with nitrate-free placebo juice which they drank twice a day. The results showed higher levels of bacteria associated with good vascular and cognitive health and lower levels of bacteria linked to disease and inflammation. Systolic blood pressure. Now keep this in mind. They're only drinking the nitrate-rich beetroot juice for 10 days. And here's the effect. And an interesting aspect too, as you delve into the research, they already had healthy blood pressure. So this makes the effect even more profound. Systolic blood pressure dropped on average by 5 points after drinking the beetroot juice. Again, the length of the time they consumed the beetroot juice, 10 days. Now we're going to go into the full research. I'm going to go a little fast and slow down during the important parts because a lot of ground to cover, but it is just intriguing, especially in reference to what can damage the oral microbiome. But to proceed, vegetable-rich diets such as the Mediterranean dietary approaches to stop hypertension, known as the DASH diet, are abundant in dietary nitrate, and oral bacteria play a key role in the pathway of NO production from such dietary nitrate. This is particularly important in older age with the capacity for endogenous NO production via the chemical enzymatic NO synthesis pathway has declined. Low NO availability contributes to the development of arterial hypertension, reduced physical and cognitive functional capacity, and increased morbidity. The important role of oral bacterial nitrate reduction as a parallel pathway for endogenous NO production is demonstrated by studies showing. This is really, and you could see it right there, but let's read through. You ready? Showing that the use of bactericidal mouthwash acutely reduces systemic NO bioavailability and elevates blood pressure, and that chronic frequent use of mouthwash is associated with elevated risk for type 2 diabetes. There's the footnotes. Now keep in mind, I'm just the messenger. So as you delve into the full study, which you can follow through the DOI citation, which I always send the link, and you can read where the researchers retrieve their information, and from there you can do your own research. But to proceed as follows. And that chronic frequent use mouse, blah, blah, blah. Conversely, increased consumption of dietary inorganic nitrate elevates NO bioavailability and reduces blood pressure, improves skeletal muscle contractility and exercise efficiency, enhances brain perfusion and cognitive function. Elevation of NO bioavailability via dietary means therefore potentially represents a powerful therapeutic to attenuate cognitive and cardiovascular decline associated with aging. Amazing. Just from basically the consumption of a nitrate-rich fruit. Now, to proceed a little further into the research itself, which is enlightening as we begin to elucidate information from this well-done, pretty good-sized research compendium in reference to beetroot juice. To proceed, quoting the researchers, we showed that it was possible to manipulate the relative proportions of these universal oral microbiome clusters via a simple short-term dietary nitrate supplementation in a population of 70 to 80-year-old individuals who followed a habitual omnivorous diet through the study. Specifically, Prevotella veillonella cluster was diminished, which basically is relative to inflammation, while Neisseria, Haemophilus, and Streptococcus rothea clusters thrived under nitrate supplementation. In terms of oral health, the Prevotella veillonella module has been associated with proteolytic metabolism and early inflammatory state of dysbiotic prognosis. This module is also predominant in smokers and positively associated with periodontitis and pneumonia in older people. Forgive the pause there. In contrast, Neisseria haemophilus dominated oral microbiome has been associated with periodontal health, younger age, lower BMI, and abstinence from smoking, which I like to see how they drew that correlation there. But still, to proceed. Neisseria haemophilus and rothea are among bacteria that dominate the oral microbiome of vegans. So it makes an interesting conjecture there. If an individual is consuming nitrate-rich foods, can they duplicate or replicate the same oral microbiome benefits of vegans themselves? To proceed as follows. While the omnivorous diet favors Prevotella, inflammatory, Streptococcus, our findings from a placebo-controlled crossover dietary intervention with nitrate-rich and nitrate-depleted beetroot juice indicated that the greater Neisseria Prevotella ratio between the two reported in vegans compared to omnivores was likely due to differences in dietary nitrate intake. By the way, too, as you delve into the full study itself, you have, for example, Difficile is also regulated down as well, as much as plenty of other nasty aspects of the microbiome, per se, without trying to interject publisher bias. Now, into the dietary amounts that were taken on a daily basis, to give you a little bit more enlightenment. Now, I want to give you this part here, and then what I'm going to do as we close out, I want to give you a little more detail in reference to the dietary forms of beetroot juice that they utilized, but I'm just going to post it up, and it takes a few days. This is a 4K video, which recorded in 4K, so you can pause it and read through it and basically draw information as you need. Quote, we surveyed the oral bacterial communities in saliva samples of 30 older people following 10 days of dietary inorganic nitrate-rich beetroot juice at approximately 750 milligrams NO3 a day, and placebo, nitrate-depleted beetroot juice at about approximately 1 milligram, which obviously is looking at 750 milligrams, so 1 milligram, you can see what I mean by about nitrate-depleted. Supplementation of randomized placebo-controlled crossover design study. Remember, they took it for 10 days. No one knew who was taking what for 10 days. And then they washed out and then took either the nitrate juice, nitrate-rich beetroot juice, or, if I say it three more times real fast, or the nitrate-rich beetroot juice in order to basically come to the conclusion. So the researchers didn't incorporate bias by accident in which one benefited them the most. However, think about that. 10 days, just 10 simple days. So put the other aspect in reference to the dietary intake of the beetroot juice. 10 days to alter the microbiome in such a way that it can favor such incredible, incredible benefit in nitrate, reference to nitric oxide reduction to help alleviate the lower NO3 aspects in reference to aging, if that wasn't too complex as at all. Bottom line, without going into the details and the chemistry per se, let's just say nitrate-rich containing foods such as spinach and beetroot juice and so on and so forth favored circulation, and circulation basically helped improve a lot of the elements, as well as reducing inflammation, increasing the benefits of the oral microbiome, reduction of periodontal disease, and in this case, in some cases, bactericidal mouthwash, in reference to type 2 diabetes. That's information which I just discovered along with you. Again, Ralph Church Channel signing off. Gratitude. Thank you. Hope you find this information of use. We're developing a nice size audience in reference to mitigating negative health impact from certain aspects and improving one's health. And again, I just appreciate you watching. We do this for fun and to benefit like this, since it's not being presented in a large aspect of the known world of information, i.e. media. I'm just grateful you watch. Again, also too, for those that want to do data analytics on Saturday, in reference to pandemic mitigation, this last Saturday we covered the R factor, we'll just say, as far as, you know, replication or reproduction factor in reference to an individual being infected, how much that plays a role in correlation or causation in reference to pandemic mitigation today. And the week before that, we covered the false positives in reference to the antigen tests with 72% false positive rate in reference to those that come up positive who are asymptomatic, tested with the current antigen test itself. And this week, we'll see what we have as hopefully things begin to wind down and things return to the old normal. Again, Ralph Trajano signing off. Gratitude. Thank you. Look forward to see you all once again next week or sooner. Catch you next time. Bye.